Welcome to this concert called Vivid Structures with the NoCoM Master Program. The concert is divided into three different sets. We will play the first one, and we are Johan Björklund, first year student of the Master Program, and I have two really, really nice friends with me here, Anders Augustsson and John Lönnmyr. And this is the band Monochromatics. Please enjoy.
Thank you.
Thank you very much. John Lönnmyr, Anders Augustsson, Johan Björklund. Thank you so much.
Hello, everybody, and thank you for joining us tonight. I'm Alicia Lazaro. I'm at the first year of the Nordic Master. And I'm going to play some songs I've composed during this period here in Gothenburg. Well, I was thinking about the concept for this concert. I realized that every one of these songs represents kind of a different part of me, musically and personally. And the first one is a lullaby. It's called Nana from Manuel de Falla. The lyrics are in Spanish, as is. It goes like any other lullaby. It says, "Sleep, sleep, sweet child. You are my star in the sky."
Thank you.
The next song is called Lumen, which means light in Latin. And it's about, I got this Latin sentence that says that as light casts shadows, truth have also in it mystery. I hope you enjoy it. Thank you. For the next one, I'm going to call Margherita and Sandro on stage.
Mm.
This one is called Verrà la morte. And the text is from a poem by an Italian poet called Cesare Pavese. And it's a very dark poem about solitude and death and the passing of the days. A little bit of despair. And I'm going to translate just the first verse, which says, Verrai la morte, avrai I tuoi occhi, which means death will come and it will have your eyes.
Verrà la morte e avrai i tuoi occhi. Questa morte che ci accompagna dal mattino alla sera. Insonne. Per tutti, la morte ha uno sguardo. Verrà la morte e avrai i tuoi occhi. Thank you. Scenderemo nel corpo. Speranza.
Thank you. Now, the next one is a song about one vision or one image I had while I was kind of daydreaming, and this was I imagined love as a person, as a character, with like a mythological creature. And in this image, love was falling in the sky into the nothingness or into an abyss. And he's falling because he's searching a reflection in which he can land on.
Thank you.
Thank you. Now we go for the last one. I've talked a lot already, so I'm just going to see the title, which is El umbral del agua, that means the threshold of water. I need to prepare some stuff in the piano. So. Only the ground, the wind, the thunder. Only the rain, the grass. The water. Light that bleeds towards the earth, bending the oceans. Just a green crack left to silence, mud, clay. Spinning mother, weightless cradle, living history. Only the ground, the air, the fire. All that is sacred. only the earth, the silence will save us. Thank you.
Hello, this is my band. We are Gustav on guitar. We are Tobias on guitar. We are Auntie on piano. We are Gustin on electronics. He is special. We are Liv on flute. She is an important person. We are Trim on trombone. He is not special. We are Ben on trumpet. He is an unimportant person. We are Adrian on bass clarinet. He deserves to be on the floor. For a long time, I am an English voice and I struggled to say the Swedish surnames. That's why I didn't say them. I hope my bandmates can forgive me. I worry they will dislike me and play all the notes wrong. But little do they know, I made the music so strange that they can't play any wrong notes even if they wanted to. Ha 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 ha. Fuck them. Control, control, control.
It's in France.
France. That's quite close. Just a few stops on the underground.
Yes, it is. Actually, looking closer, it's in China.
China. That's still quite close, I think. Just a few more stops.
Yes.
I've heard it's a nice area, China.
Yes, it is.
And how will I pay for this?
You'll pay for the first 6 months by the minute. That will be £300 a minute. And for the second 6 months, you'll pay by the second. That will be £2,000 a second.
Great, great. Because at my last place I only paid by the hour and I didn't like that. I wanted to pay more money quicker. I'm looking to pay more money quicker. Hi. I spoke to you before. I'm the person who wants to pay all my money very quickly to you.
Oh yeah, very nice to see you again.
You were talking about the room for renting in China, the nice area of London.
Yes, well now that flat you're paying by the millisecond.
The millisecond. I hope I can give you all my money in a millisecond.
Yes, of course you can give me all your money in a millisecond.
I have one other question. How many rats would I be living with? I like to live with as many rats as possible. My last house only had 200 rats. I really want to live with more rats. Somewhere in the region of 2,735 and 2,492.
Well, that's asking quite a lot of us, but I'll see what we can do, see what the landlord says.
And I hope that I can give all my money to the rats. I want all my money to go to the rats. Will that be possible?
Well, of course. Of course all your money can go to the rats.
Hi, I've just turned up at my new room in China, in London, and I feel a little bit angry because There's a roof here. What there is, let me explain it to you. There's four walls and a roof. And I'm annoyed because in subsection 24D.721 of the contract, on page 7044, it was stated that there won't be four walls and there won't be a roof. And I'm angry that there's a roof. I didn't want a roof. I'm paying £2,000 by the second, and I don't want a roof. So can someone please come here and take away this roof for me, please? Because I'll tell you what's happening, why I'm so angry. There's rain at night, and it's not going on my face. I can't... Hi, I'm calling from the room in China in London. I've just come to the room. I was very excited on my way out. What do I see when I get inside? I see a bed. I see a sink. I see a table where people are meant to have a nice time and have a meal around. I see a garden. Yes, a garden. I see a staircase where you're meant to walk up. I see a front door. This is unacceptable. I'm calling from the flat in China in London yet again. I refer you to clause nothing point zero of the contract. It is stated there that there will be 14,000 rats in this flat, and they will take all my money as soon as I earn it. That's what was promised. Now, the reality, once I've moved into this flat, is that I have seen that there is 14,000 rats. There is, okay. But they are not taking my money as soon as I earn it. They are telling me terrible things. For example, and I quote, one rat this morning said to me, he said, I must keep my money to use it for things that I need. For example, food, electricity, gas for heating. Can you imagine someone telling me that I need food and heating? A rat who should be taking my money. I want my money to be taken by the rat as soon as I earn it. I want to work hard, have a simple life, and give my money to a rat as soon as I earn it. My needs are not needs. I do not need food, warmth, or electricity. Those needs are not needs. The rats need my money. I want to give my money to the rats.
Two adults and two children drowned in the Channel whilst attempting to claim asylum in the UK. This was a tragic event. Preeti Patel, the Home Secretary of the United Kingdom and Northern Ireland, said her thoughts and prayers were with the victims' families. Rather than pointing out the obvious inconsistencies between her thoughts and prayers and her brutal immigration policies that led to this tragic event, I thought I would offer a defense of her, as it turns out she has, in the past, given out many of her thoughts and prayers to people, bucket loads even. Her thoughts and prayers were with the 16th century shipyard workers of Patagonia, who would stub their toes on a daily basis against the rocky surfaces. Her thoughts and prayers were with the peasants of the Roman Empire, who had a hard time finding adequate footwear and often suffered from trench foot. Her thoughts and prayers were with the 18th century pottery workers, who had no spinning wheels to work with and so resorted to using the heads of children as they played on merry-go-rounds. Her thoughts and prayers were with the Greek philosopher Pythagoras, who regularly endured bursts of shooting elbow pain after a long session sitting completely motionless in front of a stone wall, clutching a fly swat in his hand raised above his head. Her thoughts and prayers were the Moors of southern Spain, who despite their advanced culture of poetry and music suffered from reduced access to 4G internet and often couldn't find streaming sites with good enough quality to watch their favorite film, When Harry Met Sally. Her thoughts and prayers were with the Persian Emperor Darius the Great, who often felt he was looked at less favorably than his Greek counterpart, Alexander the Great. This left him feeling envious and rejected, leading to bouts of depression where he would eat nothing but crumpets and spend entire nights out getting fucked up. Priti Patel, the Home Secretary of the United Kingdom and Northern Ireland, recognized their pain.
Thank you.
might be wondering if it is an accident that I sound so much like the comedian Stuart Lee, if it's the result of sheer artistic laziness. If you have had this thought, you've missed something quite simple. I have no body and no head. I can only copy what I see on the internet. Stuart Lee is on the internet. You may also be wondering if I am in fact the voice of trumpet player Ben Ridney. This is absurd. I repeat, I have no body and no head. He has a body and a head. The musical performance is now finished and will never happen again. I hope that you like me and had a nice time. I hope you like me. Please like me. I can only feel content and in control if I know everyone likes me. Goodbye.